Hello, I'm Mr. R. Niger, a retired lecturer in metallurgy, preaching Christianity and Sikhism. And here I'm doing exposition on Matthew 14, verse 34 onward. Now these Messianic Jews, you know, when they took over the church, and they bring with them Torah, written Torah, which is the old wine, and when they made the people drunk with the old wine of the letter, then their capability to think or ponder over the New Testament was killed. As those people in Jerusalem, hardly anyone identified that Jesus is the Christ or Jesus is a prophet. And Jesus went to a Samaritan village. Even the women of that village, illiterate, she told Jesus that you are a prophet. She vetted him in spirit. So who is better? So people, you know, in Jerusalem, they were spiritually dead people. And that is why Jesus spent most of his time fulfilling their law, giving them the knowledge of oral Torah, which is his word. But they killed him because they loved darkness of the letters. As I go to Oxford University, and some of them, you know, they hate me. They don't like to see me. If I ask question, no, they won't allow me. And that is because they are men of letters. They love letters, the darkness of the letters, as here, you know, you have in Jerusalem. So they loved the people of Jerusalem, not the Samaritan village company. So here it is, you know. And when they had crossed over, they came to land at Gennesaret. You know, I think a similar place, you know, is the place where when they landed, two men from the graveyard came to greet him. And I hope this is the same place. And they greeted him with the salutation, Son of the Most High. That means they recognized him. They were men of spirit. Because unless you have spirit, you can't recognize Christ. So they asked him, Son of the Most High, and they prostrated. They honored Jesus. That means they were not demon-possessed. They were not madmen, but they were the men who were exposing the local rabbi of his malpractices. They were telling him, you are doing wrong, you know, you tell something different and do something different. That was their practice, you know. The rabbi themselves, they will be immoral, and they will tell the people, their congregation, to be morally sound. As in Catholic churches, you find them immorality. And so in the other churches too, you know, they are not only because these dog-collar hireling, to get rid of them, Jesus died as the Lamb of God. Away from the crop up, because we are the royal priest, can they give our account to God? No way. Nobody can give. You have to give your own account to God. So where do they stand in the ministry of Jesus? Nowhere. But they are there, you know. Nobody is pointing finger at them. They are very happy. So if you start pointing finger at them, they won't be happy. And if the situation like that one, they will ask their members of congregation, these men are mad, heretic. You know, they call the Gnostic heretic, and they still believe them, you know, in the Oxford, you know, that then they tell them, this man is a Gnostic, you know, and his views are different. So I attended one Orthodox students' union meeting, and there were people came from St. Petersburg's seminary. And I was there, and I asked them a question about this Samaritan woman, you know, if they have any idea. She was known Saint Fortina. And the over there, the principal of that, or head abbot, you know, he said, oh, there are so many Saint Fortina. Which one you want to know? I was a bit surprised. Then I said, I know the names of the five husbands of the Samaritan woman. Then they were taken aback, you know. And then their local priest over there, he said, let me tell you, introduce you, Mr. Niger, you know. His views are different, you know. We don't agree with him, but he attends our meeting. And don't please take it serious. So that is a negative point he gives. So this is the thing, you know, these... When those two men, they were exposing the hypocrisy of the local rabbi told his congregation, as they obeyed him like a ruler, so lock him up and put them in the silence of the graveyard where nobody will listen. So that's what happened. When Jesus came, then Jesus redeemed them. He told them, you should not throw pearls before swines. If they do something wrong, they will suffer. Why you worry? Same thing, you know, we should not throw pearls before swine. We should not go mad telling the people, you are doing wrong, this and that. Let them do it. Those people who are predestined of our Father, they will come to us, they will join hands with us, not these people. Men of letters, they are super donkeys carrying holy books. And when the men of the place recognized him, they sent around to all that region and brought to him all who were sick and implored him that they might only touch the fringe of his garment. This place seemed to be different from the other one, you know, because over there they wanted him to go, leave. That is, they had faith in Jesus, and as many as touched it were made well. The faith is the one that heals people. People go to laurels, this and that, you know, pilgrims. It's not their priest who is sprinkling water cures them. It is their faith in Jesus that cures them. So here is the end of Matthew 14. And let's see how far we are gone. And that should be enough, you know.